Hello and welcome to Beller Family Fun. This episode, I'm doing a full ERG delete kit on this 2005 Jeep Liberty. I got the delete kit from KB Diesel Performance. Not sponsored, just that's where I got it. Follow along. Next, I'm going to take off the fuel filter housing, and I'm going to undo these two bolts up here, which are 13 millimeter. I've got this housing off, so hopefully it'll give me a little bit more wiggle room. All right, here's where I am. I took the hose off, so now you can see this pipe. So I got all four bolts off of this EGR valve, and you can see it's loose now, so there's something underneath holding it, so moving on to that. These two bolts, pretty easy to get to. The ones in the back are very difficult. I ended up breaking it loose with a short extension and then using a long extension and just using it as a screwdriver to loosen it out. That's tough though. Oh, finally. Dang. Look at all that. Ugh. Take a look at this. This is that intake. It is pretty gunked up. This went on to here, went from the cooler into here. So the exhaust would come into the cooler, out of the cooler, into here. So I took this off in there. I started to take these out, but I was able to get this to weasel it out, as you saw. Now, back here, this is where it was. So right here is where the tube comes out and comes into this rubber tube here. So down in here, let's see if I can, there's this tube right there. So I was told there's a block off plate in here. I don't see any indication of that yet. The top bolt was busted off. You can see, right? Yeah, the top bolt was busted off, the bottom one I got out. So now I need to start disassembling this other side so that I can get to the other side of that tube. And hopefully there's some sort of block off plate because I need to block off the exhaust on this side. And then if I am up for it, I can drain the coolant and take that coolant, the exhaust cooler out because it's just useless at this point. Time to empty the coolant. The turbo cover plate I'm going to remove so I can get back to the exhaust back in here. So it has three bolts, one back here, one back here, one in here, which is about 13 millimeter. And then I can weasel this thing out. Come on out. And there's that. And what I did for the coolant is I put a bucket underneath. I got a hose on there. The cockpit for that is right there. Open that up, it drains through there. Then I removed this tube. Can you see me? I removed this tube from the bottom of the reservoir right there. And this tube and the bottom of the reservoir also had this connector on there. So now I can get back to this pipe right there, and that's what I want to take off next. I want to take this off, and then I got to figure out a block plate for that. Back out on the Jeep. I don't know, I kind of flip-flopped for a while, but now I'm back on removing the cooler, the exhaust, the ERG cooler. So like I said, exhaust comes in, goes through the cooler, goes back into the intake and causes issues. Removing that connection, now I'm removing the cooler. I just don't want problems. There's a lot more opportunity for coolant leaks, all these hoses, so that's what I'm doing now. I just broke loose the hose. I just broke this hose loose right here. There is one bolt right there. And then I undid the hose right there that goes into that Y piece down in there. And I will put that brass fitting in the Y piece to make it just a straight shot. This piece is loose and I should be able to fish it out of here now. Maybe not one-handed, but okay. It's got that little piece on there. Looks like it's been hacked off. All right, here is my predicament. That is a broken off bolt from whoever was in here last. There's a broken off bolt. I need to take this pipe. I've got it loose on both sides, but I need to break it loose, but I can't lift it up because that broken off nut is in the way. Out. All right. So that heat shield on that exhaust pipe that goes over to the cooler, this kind of holds it up because there's a clip on the back of the block. So I finally was able to get this unclamped. I pulled it all the way this way. I don't think it'll come out this way. Yeah, I don't think it's gonna come out this way. I'm gonna try to feed it back the other way. But by pulling it this way, I was able to get out that little, I don't know what that is, little sleeve. All right, let's see if I can feed that back through to the other side and get it out. All right, here it is, down here. Able to wiggle it around, and then I just dropped it straight down to the ground. Where is it? Oh yeah, that's right. There it is. There, and here's that block off plate that someone made. Stuck in there. So that was helpful, but I'm doing the whole thing. So this was the exhaust. This was after the cooler. So now, if I'm lucky, I gotta figure out how to get that cooler out of there. Cooler, this right here. So it's got this plug. This hose right here goes back into the block. So I have the plug to put into here. Maybe while I'm up here, I can go ahead and work on this Y right here and just make this a straight piece from this tube to this tube. I finally got my pliers on these clamps. Who puts the tabs of a clamp straight down? Straight down. I don't get it. Finally, I took the turbo hose off so I can get to it. All right, finally got this hose. This is that Y piece. Finally got the hose off. Now I'm gonna try to bend this up so I can actually get to this clamp here. Got that Y piece out. Now I just need to patch in that little copper piece between these two. I've got the brass piece in there and the clamps back on, actually faced up, where you can get a hold of them. Not tucked under where no one will be able to remove them. That's the EGR cooler, and it's loose. It's loose. I think there's like 4 10 millimeter bolts on there, and I've been underneath and on top and underneath trying to break it loose. I thought I stripped one out because it didn't break loose. It just started to slowly twist, and I started to cry a little bit, and then I stuck my hand up there. The bolt was just loose, so. Small victories. Bolts are still in there. I just gotta loosen them up, take them the rest of the way out, and then see how to get this cooler out of there. Cause I don't know how I'm gonna get it out. If I have to take it apart in there, I will. It's coming out. Oh, and there you go. It does come out. It does come out. Yes. Oh no. That's a bummer. Suck. What I did was the tube to the intercooler. I have pulled it back, tucked it back here, grabbed a bunch of these wires, picked this wiring harness up out and over, and that gave just enough room to squeeze through because I was already starting to think about disassembling it and pulling it out piece by piece, but that would have been miserable. I got it out, yeah! I'm so excited. And there are four 10 millimeter bolts. This small one went here and then the other three are right there. So it's in there like this, so all of them are underneath. So that one's pretty easy to get to. I actually did get under the vehicle and get that one. Of course, it's on the other side. Anyway, this shiny new intake piece, it's going to replace all of that. Yep. All right, well, you've all seen how dirty that intake is, and this is where it all goes. So as you probably have figured out, then that head is really nasty as well. So I got in there, I already got new gloves on because I dug out everything I could reach in here, dug out, scraped out everything as much. I tried not to break anything loose up where I couldn't reach it, so I won't cause hopefully any harm, but clean that out and just kind of dump it in there. It's really, you can see it's real glossy and slimy. Probably a quarter of a pound of that crud came out of there. But I cleaned and prepped the surface here. So I'm going to, I cleaned the intake hose and I'm gonna put the new tube on and get that buttoned up. I've already got my wires all connected. I do have two loose wires from that ERG system that I don't know what to do with yet, but there they are. All right, intake tube. I think this side is finished. I've got the intake hose, the tube, and here, got everything bolted up. Make sure the dipstick bracket is bolted on tight. The only plugs that I have not plugged in are the ones that go to the EGR that I'm gonna leave loose and see what happens. Got those plugged in and the bottom of the fuel filter plugged in. So I'm going to blow this side clean and move to the other side. All right, right here is the exhaust manifold. And right here is the opening that would go over to the cooler. I may have shown that earlier. And there is a worm gear clamp with this special piece inside. And I'll show you what we're gonna do with that. So, if I go back over here, this is the shape that we were just looking at. So this is the intake side where the pipes would come back in. This is the shape that we're looking at on that exhaust manifold. What I'm gonna do is take that clamp and put it on here. And when it clamps down, there's very little space there. So what I'm gonna do is take that block off plate that they had over on here for the intake, for the exhaust coming. This is where the exhaust came in on that EGR. So that was a block plate. I'm gonna take this block plate and I'm gonna trim it, and then I'm gonna clamp it on that exhaust so I won't have any exhaust leaks in the engine bay. That's my plan. All right, I rounded off that block off plate that was on the exhaust, and I kinda rounded up the edges, tried to fit it around that nice and snug. I'll put this cap on there, clamp it on, and that'll block off the exhaust from coming into the engine bay and out the exhaust pipe. Good to go. Hello, future me here. I have completed the ERG delete. Everything's great, no leaks, all is well, except the little cap that I made for the exhaust is leaking. I'm getting exhaust leak. There's a bunch of exhaust dust all in here. So I'm going back. I am using the same plate, formed it a little bit better around the exhaust manifold hole, but I'm using some of this gasket maker. Hello, Tyler. I'm using some of this gasket maker for exhaust, and it's drying right now. I'm gonna put the clamp back on, put everything back up, but other than that, everything has been working great. Heat shield. Come on. Uh-oh. Gotta go right there. All right, so I got that heat shield bolted back in, those three bolts. Then I've got the coolant reservoir. There's a piece of metal that sticks out of that firewall. This kind of slides on and threads onto these two bolts, and then there's a couple of nuts that you sink them on in. There is a electrical plug. There's also this drain plug right there. And then there is this hose here that also attaches. I want to make sure that's all connected. So I think I'm done on this side. I got the intake hose. This is the turbo's down here. This tube comes down into the inner cooler here. I got this tube back on and buttoned up tight. So I need air box and connect these two sensors. Make sure that's on tight. I don't know. I think that's getting close to buttoning it up. Got to fill up the coolant, and I'll probably run it for a little bit, check lights, things like that, and then do a oil change. But I got fresh new coolant. Forgot what the suggested one was. I'll put it down here right now. Boxes in, air filter in, clipped down. Now I just need to attach my sensors. Clip. All right, that one's in. Okay, buttoned up. Coolant, and I think we're ready to start and check for coolant leaks, which of course we will not have any. Dear Lord, please don't have any leaks. Well, we're driving. I got close to 1,000 miles on it since I've completed it, and the only issue was that exhaust leak. So I used that gasket maker, and everything is working great. I put a good 200 to 300 miles on with that gasket and sealed. No more stink, no more smells. Everything's working. No more low boost because I was getting a low boost. So that's all wrapped up. Everything's great. Thanks for watching. Catch you on the next one. What's up?
I got my car in line next as soon as you get through.
All right.